Hello everyone, so welcome back to my channel again, Intelligent Learners. In this video, we are going to discuss about the introduction of Binomial Theorem. Who has introduced us with the Binomial Theorem? Second thing, how we are using Binomial Theorem in expanding the binomial expression. See, Binomial Theorem chapter comes from a binomial expansion, right? Binomial means two terms, right? You have already learnt about binomial in the chapter polynomials. So, when we have a binomial expansion with a higher power, then how we are expanding that binomial expression with a higher power using binomial theorem? More we will discuss about in the later videos. But here is the only introduction about the binomial theorem. So please go through the complete video. The video is very short. And see the further videos on binomial theorem chapter. Right? So yes, let's start the video. And if you have any problem in any other topic of mathematics or in this topic, related to this topic, please let me tell in the comment section that, ma'am, I have this problem in this particular chapter or particular topic, right? So, yeah, so let's start the video, everyone. So, let's introduce the binomial theorem. So, first, we are taking who has introduced us with the binomial theorem. So, first, Newton has talked about the binomial theorem, but the proof has not been given by Newton. So after that, Paulson, then Pascal has talked more about the binomial theorem with the proof. But first, the very first introduction of binomial theorem has been given by Newton, right? Now, next thing that we have to discuss, where we are using the binomial theorem, that is an important point. So you have learned about this word binomial. Now, where you have learned it, so I will make you remember. You have discussed about polynomials in your earlier classes. Polynomials means the algebraic expressions, right? With the power as a whole number. So polynomial types on the basis of number of terms are monomials, binomial, trinomial, and with terms more than three are polynomials, right? Now, second C, binomial. Binomials means having two terms together. Right? Like A plus B. So two terms are there. One is A and one is B with a mathematical operator plus. If I'm saying 2x minus 3y, so two terms are there. If I'm saying A cube plus B cube, two terms are there again. A cube plus B cube. Power can be any whole number, but please remember that if we are talking about binomial, it means we are talking about only two terms. So that is all about the binomial terms, expression you can say. So suppose I'm saying A plus B, this is a binomial expression with two terms. So binomial expression with some power as a whole. Suppose I'm saying A plus B raised to the power 0. Something raised to the power 0 means 1. If I'm saying a plus b raised to the power 1, it means a plus b only. If I'm saying a plus b raised to the power, it means you are multiplying the base. If the power is 2, it means you are multiplying the base 2 times. If the power is 3, it means you are multiplying the base 3 times. If the power is 4, then you are multiplying the base how many times? 4 times, right? 4 times, similarly and so on. So it will be difficult for you to multiplying a number of brackets together. So there comes the binomial theorem. So when we have too many brackets with the same expression and we have to multiply them, we have to sum up, there comes the binomial theorem for the summing up. Okay, I think now it's clear where we are using the binomial theorem. So binomial theorem, when the calculation got longer and longer, so we are using the binomial theorem to get summed up, right? Now let's move towards the next point. Binomial theorem
is the method of expanding the expression that has been raised to a finite power. Always remember, suppose I'm saying a plus b raised to the power 7. Here the power is 7. It means we are multiplying a plus b 7 times. So it will be very difficult for us to solve it. So there we have the help of binomial theorem to solve it very easily. We will discuss it later, how to solve it using the binomial theorem. First, we are introducing it that we are solving a expression with the highest power using the binomial theorem, right? So it means through the binomial theorem, we are solving an algebraic expression easily. Okay, the calculation of algebraic expression will be easy through binomial theorem, right? Now let's discuss about the points that you have to understand regarding the expansion of the binomial expression with the finite power. So let's take an example. So this is the general form of the binomial expansion with a finite power, right? So points what you have to remember, suppose I am taking an example of a plus b raised to the power 2. So here n is equals to 2. So this is the simple identity of a square plus 2ab plus b square. Okay, 2ab plus b square. So if the power is 2, then number of terms are 3. If the power is 3, the number of terms are more. If it means if n is equals to 1, then number of terms will be 2. If n is equals to 2, then number of terms will be 3. So number of terms will be 1 more than the n. Okay, whatever the power is, the terms are 1 more than the number, the n, right? Second thing you have to remember, this power is also called as indices. Okay, power and indices means the same thing, right? Third thing that you have to understand, if here the power is 2, then every term has the power equals to 2. So here only variable is a. So here the power of a is what? 2. Here two variables are there and both has power 1, 1. So a, b means a raised to the power 1 and b raised to the power 1. Add them, so the power is 2. Here only b is there, so power is 2. So it means every term has the same power equals to n. Okay? So this is the second thing. Third thing that you have to remember, if the first variable is a and the second first term is a and the second term is b, it means the power of first term will be decreasing and the power of second term will be increasing, right? So like, for example, I'm just taking an example. I'm taking an example of 3, power 3. So this is also an identity, that is a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square. So this is the total identity. So please understand, here the power of a is what? 3. Then power of a is 2. Then power of, sorry, this I have written it wrong. Like this. So here the power of a is 3, power of a is 2, power of a is 1, and here the power of a is nothing, means a means 0. That is 1. So means power of a is decreasing. But the power of b is increasing. Like here b is not there, it means b raised to the power 0, then b raised to the power 1, then b raised to the power 2, and b raised to the power 3. So please remember this thing. First variable power is in the decreasing order and second term power is in the increasing order. Okay, so these are the points that you have to learn it, remember it. Okay, so this is the introduction of a binomial theorem. Okay, so who has introduced it? Where we are using it? We are using it to solve the binomial expression with a finite power. Right now, we are only talking about the positive powers and the things that you have to remember while expanding the powers is 1, 2, 3. And the fourth one is the first term power is in the decreasing order and second term power is in the decreasing order, that you have to remember, right? So yeah, thank you everyone.